Well, hello everybody. Welcome to today's Coffee Talk. Today we're talking about the Inventory to GL Reconciliation Report. So it's a very powerful report to help you reconcile with your general ledger, but it's a little tricky to read. So I'm just going to go over the report with you and show you what some of the, well, the information that it's giving you and how to read it and where to find the corresponding GL accounts. So let me go over here to Departments, Financial Management, Inventory. And down here under reports, we have the inventory to GL reconcile. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that. This is a test database, so I'm running it as of a future date. Of course, you'll run it as of whatever date you're trying to analyze, usually the last date of the prior period. And I'm going to go ahead and preview it. Now, my report is only a few pages long. Most reports in a live system, this report tends to be breathtakingly long. A lot of people will preview it and then save it as a PDF rather than printing it because it can be hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of pages. That said, it can take a few minutes to run, so be patient. Once you've got it, this is the data that it's showing you. It's showing you the inventory valuation, what's been received and hasn't been invoiced yet, what's been shipped but not invoiced yet, and then we're going to go ahead and look at the total expected cost, and then skip ahead to the inventory value to be posted, and more importantly, the inventory value posted to GL. So this inventory value posted to GL is really what's going to end up tying to your general ledger when you look at all your inventory accounts. But we're just going to go through these different columns one by one and show you where to get their totals. So right now under the inventory valuation, if I go to the end of my report, I see here I've got my totals. So where are these totals coming from? Well, they tie together with some of our mappings in our system. So the inventory valuation column looks at the inventory posting setup. So let's go ahead and pull that up. Now the inventory posting setup has two critical columns that that report or that column in that report is evaluating. It's looking at the inventory account and the inventory account interim. Let me just make this bigger so you can see it. There we go. So these are the two columns that point to the GL accounts that are being added up to create that inventory valuation column on the report. So what you'll do is you'll look in here to see which GL accounts are being evaluated, and you'll run your trial balance filtering on these two accounts for the same date range, and it should tie to the total in that column. So let's go back to that report, right? So that was the inventory valuation column. So now when you go to your trial balance, if I go to the general ledger reports, I like the trial balance detail summary report. You're going to put in those two accounts or those range of accounts that you saw in those two columns. So in this case, I've got 14100 and 14200 and 14300. And then my interim accounts were 14101 and 14201. And you'll put in the date. The date should correspond to the same date that you ran the report. So I ran it as of the 27th. All right. And there's my ending balance. So now I can start my evaluation process and see, you know, whether those two columns are equal to each other and then dig into those accounts to find any discrepancies. So that was the inventory valuation column. Let's just go back to that report. And the next column is the received not invoiced. The received not invoiced actually looks at the same table we were just looking at, the inventory posting setup, but it's only evaluating the inventory account interim column. So let's just open that up again. So we have our inventory posting setup. And again, this is the inventory account interim. So the received not invoiced column is looking at the GL accounts in here. So again, I would just go back to my trial balance and I would only evaluate these GL accounts and my totals should be the same. All right. Now the next is the ship not invoiced That's a little different. That actually looks at your general posting setup. So this particular column should tie to the accounts in the general posting setup. And it's looking at the cost of goods account interim column. All right, so again, you'll look at the GL accounts that are set up in here, and those are the accounts that you'll put on your trial balance to tie to the inventory to GL reconcile report. Now the next column, the total expected cost, this one right here, the total expected cost is actually the sum of the received not invoiced and the shipped not invoiced column. So that actually we don't worry too much about because it's just calculating what we've already looked up in our setups. So I'm going to go ahead and skip ahead now to the expected cost to be posted. So again, these are the critical columns that you're looking at. The expected cost to be posted and the inventory value to be posted, those should both be zero. And I believe in my case they are. Yes, they're both zero. So what you want to do is if you're seeing numbers in the inventory cost to be posted or the inventory value to be posted, you should run your post inventory to GL function. Now, if that's not something you normally do, don't do it. You'll need to contact us. But if it's something that you run on a periodic basis, some people run it daily, weekly, monthly, you're just going to want to run that process again manually. Sometimes people automate it to run at night, so you might want to do a quick one manually during the day. And once you've done the post invoice to GL function, you'll just print this report again and make sure that those two columns are zero. If they're not, then there's something stuck out there that needs to be addressed. That said, your inventory value posted to GL column takes into account everything, and that should tie to all your inventory accounts and your inventory interim accounts that are in your general ledger. That's it. That's how to read this report, and that's how to find which account has the problem. I hope that helps you out, especially with your end coming up with reconciling your inventory to your GL. Thanks.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.